Hi friends, today we are going to see how to upload and download files in JMeter. Before we begin, I would like to share few important tips when you script file upload and download in JMeter. Before you begin recording the process of file uploading and downloading, make sure that you have understood how file upload and download process works in your application. You can use DevTools to trace the request, or you can use Fiddler. So in this example, I am going to demonstrate file upload and download using tinypng.com. So tinypng.com is an online simple utility where you can compress your PNG and JPG files. So this is only for demonstration purpose, and there are two flavors of file uploading and downloading. So one is using the actual application, and you can also leverage the developer API. To understand, I'm going to use the whole application, and I'm not going to record anything. I'm going to show you how to file upload and download works and how we can convert that into JMeter script. So before you start recording, as I said, you have to use DevTools to understand how this process works. So in this case, what I'm going to do is I'm going to open DevTool and I'm clicking on Network tab. So right now there is no communication being sent from the browser to the server. Now I'm going to upload a simple file, and once I selected the file, TinyPNG automatically compresses and it will give an output, and I can use this download link to download the actual compressed file. And here you can see the compression ratio, and there are other options like download all and save to Dropbox. But in the network tab, you can see only one call being sent, which is shrink. So request URL is tinypng.com/web/shrink, and the request method is post. And you can see the request headers like authority, method, accept encoding, and other details. And the response is, there is no response here because it's not loading here. And also other requests are the Google Analytics, which we do not need. And there is some SVG file, again, we do not need. And there is a DC, again, it's a Google double click, which we can ignore these three requests. So our main aim is to script this particular shrink call in JMeter and see how it works. So to begin, just open any template, or you can add these elements. And the first element is I'm going to create a HTTP sampler. So just right click, add sampler, HTTP sampler, HTTP request. And in the server name, the base URL, which is nothing but tinypng.com. And the method is post, and the path is web/shrink. And here, there is no file being sent. So to send a file, you need to leverage files upload tab. In the files upload tab, just enter which file you want to upload. No need to enter any path, because by default, JMeter will pick the path from the bin folder. So you need to keep the file inside the bin folder and just mention the file name with the extension. So in this case, I have kept my timing-overview.png file in my bin folder. Here is the file. The total size is 34 KB. So if I send the request, what will happen is JMeter will upload this file to this particular path. Now we will execute the sampler. So now this is successful. The response code is 200, and now we will see the response data. So response data is in JSON format. So just change the format to JSON path tester. And here you could see the size, which is 34 KB, type is PNG, and the output is the compressed volume, which is less than the 34 K, and the type is PNG again, and the width of the file, height of the file, the ratio, compression ratio, and the output URL. So if you open this particular URL in the browser, what will happen is it will download the compressed file. See? Now our next step is to grab this URL and send it in the next request to download the file. So to extract the URL, I'm using a regular expression extractor. So in the reference name, I'm entering output file, and this is the regular expression. Template is 1, match number is 1, and default value is error. And in the HTTP request, I'm entering HTTPS and the output file. So to save the output file format, which is PNG, I'm using save responses to a file. So just right click, add listener, save responses to a file. So in this element, you need to enter the output, the file name prefix as output, and only save the successful responses only. Now we will execute this whole script, and we will make sure that the download file request is successful and it is saving the actual output in the bin folder. So now the upload file is successful and download also successful. So just change the type to text, click on response data. Here you can see the actual image, which is compressed one from the tiny PNG. Now go to bin folder, refresh it, and here you could see output 1.png. So the time is 8:04, the current time is 8:05. So this is the recent one. So just refresh. Yes. So once you open this one, you will get the compressed image of the uploaded file. So the main important thing to remember is make sure that you are leveraging files upload in JMeter. And make sure that you have kept the file in the bin folder and enter the file name only. And make sure that you have understood how the file upload and download process works in your application. In some of the application, they might use a unique value every time. For example, the development team, they would have thought they can have a unique string like time in milliseconds, or they will have a session ID, etc. So in that case, you need to correlate those values also, and make sure that your request has the appropriate headers. So that is another point. And make sure you are downloading the file and saving it using save responses to a file. So this particular elements are very high memory consuming during the load testing. So you can basically, for scripting purpose, you can use this, but for the actual purpose, unless the business requirement is to download all the files, just disable this, and you can just send the URL only. Okay. So I hope this session is pretty useful, and make sure that you have subscribed to QA Insights podcast and QA Insights YouTube channel. Thanks for listening.